whispering to one another, being like, oh, should we, what do we do? Do we call security? Maybe we should call a cop. And he was just ranting and raving. Because clearly there was something wrong with him. Now, he had something wrong with him. Had he been in a wheelchair, had he been on crutches because he was missing part of a limb, had he had some sort of physical affliction that we could relate to a little bit more, rather than going, oh, crap, should we call the cops? Everyone would have been like, can I help you to your car? Is there anything I can do? God bless you and happy holidays, sir. So the line in the sand I've decided to draw is that, well, we treat people with mental issues in this country like ass. We really do. If they're in a wheelchair, hey, we'll extend every courtesy. But if there's something not right upstairs, we treat them with suspicion, scorn, and disdain. And that's not okay. That said, having met Creed singer Scott Stapp numerous times back in the day, having played with him, I can almost confidently 100% say that his particular condition is related to the fact that he is a drug addict. He really is. I mean, you know, and I think he's been very open about it in the past. But the level of paranoia that he's experiencing right now, I would hazard a guess, has something to do with all that heroin, crack, and meth he's been so fond of doing in the past while proclaiming himself a holy roller and doing Jesus Christ poses on stage. He's wildly delusional, to the point where I think he actually finds Creed music to be good. We'll get into exactly what's going on with him a little later on in the show. But like I said, we drew a line in the sand about not making fun of people with mental issues. I don't think Scott Stapp has a mental issue. I think he just went so far down the hole of drug use, drug abuse. He pissed away all the gifts that he'd been given to the point where he's now suffering the consequences. And we'll talk about exactly what those consequences are later on in the show. What else, Funkhauser?
Well, David Prowse, he's the...
The original Darth Vader. Prowse, I think. I don't know. Prowse, whatever.
Well, he doesn't remember it either because he says he has dementia.
Oh.
Bummer.
Yeah, that is a bummer. On the bright side, he'll soon forget that Jar Jar Binks ever existed in the Star Wars universe. Funkhauser doesn't get that because he's never seen Star Wars, but everybody else in the world understands exactly what I'm talking about.
I heard that there's a new trailer out, don't you know, Honda Hinda.
Is that a good...
That's sad. Yeah, that's something like that. Yeah, that's sad. Dementia's a tough one to go. That's a tough road to hoe. It runs in my family. I think it might be setting on in me a little bit early. But when you see people that are actually brilliant start to kind of lose control of what's going on upstairs, that's a tough one. That's a really, really tough one. But it's part of getting old, part of years ticking on, and part of life, I suppose. What else?
Bill Cosby's in the news still. He dropped from number three, to 2,615 on a list of the most trusted celebrities. It's quite a plunge there.
Yeah, quite a plunge there. On the bright side, his standing on the list of most rapey celebrities significantly improved. What else?
On the rise. Shia LaBeouf claims he was raped in an art gallery. I know you talked about this.
Sorry, but you've finally gone too far, Bill Cosby, too far. No, we'll get to exactly what happened to Shia LaBeouf a little later on in the show. Go on.
Kendra Wilkinson, she says she first had sex with Hugh Hefner when she was 18 years old.
I think technically it was 22 since it took him 4 years to get an erection, but potato, potato. love at first sight of his wallet. Go on.
Billy Idol turned 59 yesterday.
he was given one slice of cake for his birthday. Then, with a rebel yell, he asked for more, more, more. The entire day's been leading up to that punchline, and pretty much from here on in, I got almost nothing. What else?
You remember that girl Susan Boyle?
Yes, yeah.
Well, she's...
I dreamed a dream. The one that everybody scoffed and mocked when she appeared on, like, some version of American Idol, like English Idol or something like that, and then she just brought the house down because she sang her sweet patootie off, that one?
Yeah, she's got her first boyfriend at age 53.
Oh, good. But only after she made sure that she got along with his seeing eye dog.
Not cool.
Yeah, no, it's probably not all right. I'll do some atonement later. What else?
Former Spice Girl Mel B, she said she once had a 4-year relationship with a woman.
Oh, Mel B. Yep. That explains the nickname she had for a little bit. Scissors Spice. Go on.
Experts.
It's amazing that you had a pair of scissors sitting there.
Yeah, Foley right there. Experts say the sale of sex robots to the general public is just a few years away.
Right. So as Bill Cosby calls it, 30 years too late. Sex robot, would you or wouldn't you?
Me?
Yeah.
Yeah.
My objection to the sex robot is not a moral thing. I just I'm hesitant to put a part of myself into a machine that could potentially rip it off. I think I'll wait until you try it before I have my first go around on one of those things.
Shoulders off, ladies, pimps, too gone, push your shoulders off. Sometimes you feel like it's cool to turn the other cheek and give people the benefit of the doubt even when they don't deserve it. And sometimes you feel good about yourself for being the better person and doing that. Well, this is not one of those times. I don't think you realize what's on my mind. I've been too nice, way too long. I think I want you to know just what is going on. So bite me, you're a fucking bag of suck. Every second I'm around you, I put down some bad luck.
Go ahead, favorite the show and enjoy AD on the go. iHeartRadio presents AD.
Yep, iHeartRadio presents AD. Makes it sound big and impressive, which is not what she said. Did you stay off social media, Funkhauser, when it came to commenting on what was going on in Ferguson over the last week or so?
Yeah.
You did?
Yeah. I turned my phone off, walked away.
Yeah. You know, there's no evidence of me making any comments on social media about what was going on because all my tweets about how being a looter in the face of a human rights issue being pointless, all those tweets where I was saying, hey, the violence is really senseless. It's not helping anything. It's not helping anybody's cause to heave a brick through the window of a small business owner. It's not helping anybody's cause to make part of your community less when you're trying to bolster it. All those tweets got flagged as being racist. It was almost like a whole bunch of people in Ferguson just got new laptops or something. Anyways, let's finish up the news and get on to the rape of Shia LaBeouf.
Well, okay. Let's see, where are we? There's a growing demand online for ugly Christmas sweaters.
Yeah. Or as the receptionist who just sent our entire company a photo of her cat dressed in elf ears knows them, sweaters. You know what that is? You know what that's from? That's from Ironic Hipsters. We're having an ugly sweater party. It's just, yeah. They have ugly... The whole idea of having an ugly sweater party, I kind of sort of got. Because you could just, you know, dig up some sort of horrible relic from the 70s that used to belong to your mom or some extended piece of your older family and just be like, hey, here's my ugly Christmas sweater. But now they've started selling them in Urban Outfitters for like $60 a pop or something like that. Because hipsters, you're being pandered to in exactly the same way Nickelback fans are. You're just not smart enough to recognize it. Go on.
President Obama and his daughters bought 17 books at a bookstore on Friday.
Yeah. Unfortunately, Basic Economics for Dummies, not one of them. And with that, let's get into the show proper, shall we? Did you participate in the Black Friday shenanigans? Did you do any shopping, Funkhauser?
I tried.
Really?
I didn't buy anything, though. I went to a bookstore. I really did.
Obama bought all the books before you got a chance to get anything you were interested in?
Yeah. A lot of people, though. A whole lot of people.
Yeah. All things considered, this year's Black Friday seems like it had... It was a little more civilized. It had fewer criminal incidents than Black Fridays in the past. Maybe spreading it out and having it ruin Thanksgiving is actually a good thing. I don't know. I do know this, though. Someone had to mess up on Black Friday in a big way. And this is the best one I've heard, at least until now. Maybe more will come out as the week draws on. But police in Central Valley, which is in New York, got a call around 4 a.m. this past Friday, just gone by, Black Friday, about a crying 4-year-old boy wandering around a hotel alone.